Good morning. I'm very happy to see all of you. It seems full of energy. What about your energy this morning? Okay, and as I mentioned yesterday, I planned 5 presentations, and this is the 5th. The last one from yesterday, but due to the delay in the morning, we could not finalize. So today we have to make it a bit more quicker. And this is on one hand, this is very important. On the other hand, it's also a very basic, quite basic things. And because from several years ago, we started the implementation of VEVT V3, and as you know that in V3, we have added a lot of new scans, more scans than we have common? No. New scans and more scans than that in V1. And I'll show you, let's come to it one by one. And before starting of this presentation, again, I would like to show you my questions. How many legs are there for end-to-end?
3 legs.
This is too easy, huh? And what are they?
Leg one, leg two, leg three.
Very easy. And the leg one performance is measured from which scan to which scan?
A, B, C.
Okay. Leg two performance is measured from C to D, right? And leg three from D to H. To the first delivery scan, no matter it is the EDH or EMH or EMI.
Yes.
Okay, and last one. What are the main functions of EDA and EDF and EDH? What is the meaning for EDA? Anybody? And the EDF? EDA. How the inbound OE? And the EDF? How in delivery post office? And the EDH?
Error collection
form. Kind of delivery in a settled place. Agreed by the GRC.
Yes.
It could be a shop, could be a delivery depot, could be a mailbox, or it could be everything. Okay. Purpose of planning. This is the purpose for why we added some new scans. Because we would like to make our operation more complete and more fitting or suitable for the actual situation. Okay, this is the steps for export for leg one. You see, from the collected from post office, that's EMA, and then in the outbound OE, arrived in the OE EMB, leaving the OE EMC, and in the middle, if it is terminated, that's EXD. And I don't know if all of you have this step, maybe not all of you, export customs or security. I visited some countries and I did not see the export security or export customs, but I also saw some in some countries you have, not maybe not all. Or in some countries, some of you have this procedure, but you do not make any scan, right? You have export security checking. Which maybe you should make EXA enter into the security And he has to see outside, leaving the security checking. Or for the security checking, if the item is held, you can make the EMS fee. But I noticed that in most of the countries, maybe you do not make this scan. Although maybe you have this procedure, and this is for outbound items, usually customs or securities, they check, but not as seriously as import, right? Situation. And export cancellation, that's EXX. EXX means in the process of outbound, it was terminated and maybe returned back. And EXD means held in the outbound OE. This EXD is similar like what I mentioned just now, EBA, held in the inbound OE, but this is held in the outbound OE. So generally speaking, before the items, all items go, you put everything into the bill bag and you make a purchase scan. And for the time for making this purchase, it is also somewhat different. Because maybe some of you make this purchase immediately. As soon as all the items are wrapped in the mail bag, and some of you may leave a bit more relaxed time, because in the outbound security checking, possibly some of the items could have some problem and could be picked out. So the purchase maybe need to be done, maybe again, once more, or something. So some of you make a purchase a bit later, after you can make sure everything is okay. Now let's come to that one, scans one by one. These are the newly added scans for that one. As I mentioned, yesterday, the newly added scan in lab one, all using X for export. X. So if you see EX, what? That's in the lab one. That is in the lab one. So EXA, item presented to the security, to the outbound security, EXB, how? In the security, EXC, return number security checking, and the EXC, held and outbound office of change, and the EXX, export cancellation. So, as you saw just now, as you have seen in this page. And so, the total procedure for export or outbound is usually something like this. See, from EMA to speed, and then to EMB, they arrive in the OE, and after arriving in the OE, sent to security checking, maybe held, maybe not held, and then leave the security checking. Maybe held in the outbound OE, and no matter what, finally it entered to EMC, ready to go. And possibly export cancellation. And here, EMJ and K, in some countries, some of the items need a, what we call, transit up here. Arrived at the transit office of exchange, in some countries or some items need this procedure. Maybe in most cases, maybe especially for big volume operators. For some smaller volume operators, maybe you will need this transfer in another bigger player. Like islands, countries, maybe you need this in New Zealand or in Australia. Okay, this is EMA for posting, which means the item is posted at the postal counter or picked up by our staff. I received a postage was created. That's a result of online postage. But the intent could be made online. Okay, and usually when we make the EMA scan or making the either step of EMA, usually we provide the customer a kind of a video, which is CN22 or CN23, and according to the latest procedure, we are now trying to make CN22, and now we are just promoting CN23 because this is more complete. It contains complete information for ICANN. And now we are encouraging all of us, all people, to use ICANN, to send ICANN, right? So in the CN23, these basic elements, item number, sender's information, receiver's information, all the necessary information for ICANN are collected at the same time. When you make the A scan, when you make the posting. And the EMB arrived at the outward, at outbound OE. It's very easy. I don't think we need much time. And then EXA, I can present it to the passport security. And then EXB, help. By the export of the customs or security, and if you really need to make this scan, please remember you need to select a reason code. This is very similar like the other scan for inbound, for example, you know. For inbound, if it is held by the customs, it is the EME, right? Yes. This is similar. This is for export. The EME is for inbound. This is for outbound. And both of them are used for being held by the customs. And so, no matter you select the EXP scan, or you make the EME scan, please don't forget to select the reason code. You must have a reason code. And for EXC, item return from the security checking, this is similar like inbound, similar like EDC, right? And the EXC item held at the outbound office OE. This is not held by the security. This is held by ourselves because of some reason. Maybe item is damaged, or maybe item has incomplete address, or maybe some documentation lost, or maybe something. Also, if you make this scan, you do not forget you have to make a reason, select a reason code, and then select an action code. Then EXX. This is an export cancellation. And because of whatever reason, if the item, outbound item, should be cancelled, you have to release the link. EXX for cancellation. in the last scan in the level 1, that's EMC departure from the outbound OE. Okay, this is the whole procedure about the level 1 from A scan to C scan. And in the middle, there could be, there should be an ESP, and there could be EXA, EXB, EXC, or could be EXS, so maybe, or could be held in the OE, that's the EXD. So now we have a general idea about that one, right? And now for transit. For some of the items, you need this procedure for transit. So in case of transit, when the item enter into the transit OE, EMJ, and leave the transit OE, EMK. Okay, this is the inbound. That's three. For lab 3, EMD started from the EMD, and then maybe have the big, let's talk about the basic, very basic one. Enter into the OE, EMD, and leave the OE, in most cases, leave the OE as EMF, and enter into the delivery post office, EMG, and attempt the delivery, EMH, final delivery, EMI. This is a very basic. And then in the middle, there could be EDA, because the item could be detained in the inbound OE because of different reasons. And this one, DBE, I try to track some of your or most of your item tracking, and I did not find a lot of EDD and EDE. These two scans are not so often used by most of you. Not so often. But I noticed that EMG in most cases you're using the scan to prove that the item arrived in the delivery post office. And I also noticed customs, as you know that you are making EDB and EDC. But after this presentation, in my next presentation, I would like to show you all of the performance of all of you. And I'm sorry to see that not all of you are making complete inbound customs scans. I don't believe you have no need to send it to customs, okay? But in some countries you are not making.
So this for me, and I have done it in law, but I know for our configuration, I just have to enable these things on my table. So for that EDD that you don't see, a lot of people's posts, when we have to enable, we would have to disable that. Their system in some kind of way, it will come out in the error. So that's one reason why you don't see a lot of people when they EDD scan. It's some kind of error in the programming. I thought it was just our system, but if you're not seeing it.
All it is included in the necessary procedure in the local system. Or maybe they are making that in their domestic system, but maybe not transmitted into the.
Well, we would get asked to say, because it would be.
Yes. Yeah, I know in most cases, in most of your country, you are using two systems, and in the OE, you are using, I guess, directly. So all the scan for EMD, EMF, in most cases, is directly scanned, and the data directly and also for EDB, EME, or EDC, directly scanned and directly transmitted into the big system. But for all the scans that happen in the collecting, picking up, in the removed customs, or in delivery depot, maybe you directly make the scan in your domestic system, and then you need another transmission from your domestic system to the IPS. So on this, on the way of, or if you make a transmission in this way, sometimes some error could happen because of the failure of transmission, because of the format, because of the transmission time or something. But anyway, we can generally divide our inbound scans, like you see EMB, and we have the info in the inbound, in the inbound OE, that's EBA, and EMF is here, and leave is the OE, and enter into the delivery post office, EMG, and until H&I. And why we have import customs and remove import customs? And because in some of the countries, the custom clearance, in most cases, that's located in your OE. So in most cases, the inbound custom clearance should happen here, right? Should happen in the OE between EMD and EMM, in between this procedure. But in some other countries, the custom clearance may happen in another place. And also in some countries, custom clearance may, custom security, custom clearance may happen in two different OEs, such as China. Because the country is bigger, and they have different OE, inbound OEs, and their OEs are maybe first level and second level. So for some of the many items may enter, for example, enter into Beijing, and in Beijing, maybe no custom clearance, but maybe some simple custom clearance checking. So you need to make EDB and EDC, but when the item transported to the second level OE, another round of custom clearance may happen again. So in some countries, the custom clearance may happen twice in two different OEs. But according to the rule of EBTV3, we calculate only one custom clearance, all the first time, all the second time. And also for EMD, we calculate only the first one. So if you make a repeated EMD, or if you make a repeated EDB, we measure only the first EDB. If you make a repeated EDC in first time and second time, we calculate only the first EDB and first EDC. So if you make repeated EDB and EDC later, it is no use. And the time in between EDB, the second EDB and EDC will not be deducted for the on-time delivery measurement calculation. So that's why I have given suggestions. China Post, maybe in the first OE, you make the EDB and EDC, but in the second OE, maybe you can select EDA instead, use EDA instead of EDB and EDC. Okay, let's come to this one by one. As you can find that in the inbound ELX3 procedure, the newly added scans are all start from B, EDA, EDB, EDC. EDA held in the inbound OE, and EDB sent to custom, EDC leave the custom, EDB sent into sorting center, EDE out of sorting center, EDF held at delivery airport, and EDG item out for physical delivery. I noticed that most of you are making this one, EDG out for physical delivery. And EDH arrived at the collection point for picking up. And during the last few years, during the pandemic, I found that more countries, more posts are using this one for EDH. Because many countries, it's not allowed to make that hand-to-hand delivery. So you have to leave the item somewhere, this time or read by the addressee. And during the pandemic, I myself also gave my suggestions for using of EDH many times to some of you. And finally, EDS, the import terminal. Now, let's come to that. This is a whole procedure about the import. This is a cookie, maybe not exactly the same in all of your import procedure. But in most of the cases, the procedure is something like this. As you imagine, in most countries, custom clearance happen just in the inbound OE. So, see, for inbound scan, that's the EMD, and then maybe EDA. Well, this EDA could happen maybe here. All EDA could happen also after EDC. Maybe it could before EDB or could be after EDC. And after a while, I will give a bit more explanations about how to make a better use of EDA. Okay? And then EDB into custom, EME out by the custom. Some of you are making EDB and EDC without making any EME. Or maybe your country custom refused to detain your items. I don't know. And EMF, leave the inbound OE, and EDD into shopping center, EDE out of the shopping center, not all of you are making this. And EMG arrive into delivery office, and EDF held at delivery level. This held is not by customer, not by anybody else, it's by ourselves. And EDG off for physical delivery, EDH put it there waiting for delivery, and the EDX in on the terminated, and EMH has successful physical delivery, and until EMI final delivery. Let's come to this number one, EMD arriving, and EDA held in the inbound OE. So the reason for the item to be held could be because the item is damaged, because an incomplete address, because of security reason, or because any other possibilities. Usually it is not used in connection with customers. Custom became is custom. That's something we should use the EDP and the EDC, right? But for the depend for the EDP not OE, you can use the EDA. This is not custom depend. And also if you make an EDA, you must select a proper reason code and a proper action code. You must. And the EDB, item presented to customs, we don't need to say too much, but the biggest problem for some of us, for EDB and the EME and the EDC scan, for the custom clearance scan, the biggest problem now for most of us or for some of us are the basic data element not complete. Because when you make these three scans, you need to configure complete data elements in your system. And sometime later, maybe this afternoon or maybe tomorrow, we'll come to FOP compliance report. I will maybe in the next presentation, I can show you that who of you still do not have complete data elements for EDC, for EDB, EDC, and EME scans, for custom clearance scans. We have the more concentrated problem on this aspect. And the EMF departure from your inbound OE. Now the most possible scenario for inbound start from EMP and to inbound OE start from EMP and from EMF. And in the middle, there could be no customs involvement. And in most of the countries, maybe the inbound document, maybe does not, you do not need for inbound customs clearance, maybe. So some of the items may directly go from EMP to EMF. But if this is in case of item number. Okay, in case of items handed in to the customs, if the item is not held, so directly from EDB to EDC. So the circulation of the procedure could be like this. The EDB sent into customs, and if customs do not detain, drop the EDC, and then the EMF code. And also could be if the item is held. So usually you need to make an EME. So the scenario could be like EMD, and then EDB handed into the customs and detained by customs, make an EME. And then after the meeting, after the release, EDC and EMS go. Okay, here, I would also like to talk one small topic, like the automated scan. As I found in many posts, you like to do something like the automated scan. And many of you are doing like your IT people are very clever and they made the automated scan like immediately after EMD, usually closely, automatically closed by followed by EDB. No matter the items handed, really handed in or not, automated EDB. and then some problem could happen, and the item may not be handed in to customs. So you make automated easy, but when you make EMF, an automated TDC in front of before EMF happen, it's okay. I mean, if we just follow the measurement methodology, it's okay. But sometimes, if the item really need to be detained by the customs, and then problem happen, another EDV may happen. So I saw in many of your countries, not only one or two or three, quite a few. In your countries, from time to time, you can find two EDV. The first EDV is automated, closely follow this one. And then maybe 1 hour or a few hours later, a true EDV may happen. And then if first EDC and second EDC, so repeated EDV and EDC may happen. This problem, because according to our methodology of measurement, we take only the first EDV and the first EDC. So if you make complete the EDV and the EDC, it may make more trouble. I'm not complaining that you must stop automated scan, but if you are using that, please make it more reasonable or more complete. Okay. And this is EDD and EDE. You do not need to spend too much time. And EMG arrival at delivery box numbers. And this is EDF. Item held at the delivery office. I noticed that in some of the posts, when the item arrived into the delivery post office, you still need to do something. For example, according to what I saw in Brunei, I remember, for some inbound items, when the customs need to collect maybe tax, the tax could be collected on the level of inbound OE in your capital city, in the OE, and also could be in the delivery post office, because the situation I saw in Brunei is very different. In almost every local post office, they have not only postal people, but also on the other side, maybe one person on behalf of customs. And even in local post office, they have one custom people collecting tax or doing related business. So this is very special. And when the item arrived into the delivery post office, if something happened, what can you do to make the on-time delivery measurement stop for a while? So the best usage could be EDF. If you make an EDF scan, the on-time delivery measurement will force stop at that point, until you make the final delivery and it is released, but the delivery, the total delivery procedure ended. So if you can make a better use of EDF, you can greatly or obviously improve your on-time delivery. So that when item is detained in the delivery post office by some certain reason, the time will not be calculated for the on-time delivery measurement. So this is EDF. The other one is EDA, and just now I mentioned. And I noticed that in some of your OEs, when the custom would like to collect, for example, collect the tax, and you make a, they are not, maybe not actually detain your item because the item is still in the hand of post, right? In our warehouse, it's namely controlled by the customer, but actually controlled by ourselves. Because we need to notify the addressee to pay the tax. And then after the tax is cleared, the item could be delivered. So in this case, you do not need to make a, maybe sometimes you do not need to make a EDB at the beginning, and while waiting for so many days for tax payment, and after that you make EDC, so the custom clearance time could be too long, very long. So actually, if the custom make a decision to collect the tax, you can take it as the custom clearance has been namely ended. So you can make EDC. The custom clearance is ended, and then you make the EDA, because this item is still detained in the OE. And you can select the reason code, because waiting for the tax, or waiting for payment for tax. And also you can select a action plan, an action code, like addressee notify, because you are notifying the addressee to pay the tax. So until this item, the tax of this item, all the missed documents provided, and the customer really needs the upgrade of the electrical. And until then, you make the EMS. And in that case, the time between EMA to EMF will now be calculated for on-time delivery measurement. So that period of time will be deducted for the calculation for on-time delivery. So I have made this this suggestion is not for all of you, only for those who, if your customer really need, really agree to release them, if only that one is done, if only, and also everything is controlled by the post, by ourselves. So in this case, you can consider better using of EDA in OE or EMF in the delivery post office, so that when the customer make the tracking, they can see the real tracking result, because this item is waiting for payment of tax or waiting for the next step. It is held in OE or it is held in the delivery post office, and they are waiting for your next action. And also, it's good for us. The time for the detain for the several days time for waiting, it could be deducted by the for on-time delivery measurement. Because for most of us, or almost all of us, the biggest problem for on-time delivery performance is still late performance. So you can more or less improve your on-time delivery by very reasonable conversation of scans. So in the last presentation of this workshop, I have prepared a specific suggested action plans for each of you. So maybe to some of you, maybe I have similar suggestions. Okay. That's the EMF and the EDG and the EMSD this is also something new for B3. In B1, if it is terminated, it is terminated. And in B3, if the inbound item terminated, and if you make a reasonable EMS, if you make a reasonable EMS and follow with reasonable other scans, and if you selected the proper reason code, for this item, you can also receive a payment like delivery, although you did not actually deliver this item. If you make a proper data scans and send it back, you still can receive a payment for delivery because you have made related process. And the EDH, I noticed that within this recent 2 years, EDH are more and more widely used by more and more from you, because you have realized to put this the privilege for making this delivery. And actually, we are also making our delivery like this more and more. And the EMH, this EMH is somewhat different than before. This EMH now means only physical delivery, which means as a matter of fact, you did physical delivery but failed. If you really did not make any physical delivery, you should make it also, if you can make it deliver, you should make EMH, not EMH. EMH is used only for actually physical delivery material. And also, please remember, if you make an EMH scan, you must select a proper reason code and a proper action code. A reason code to show why you failed for the physical delivery. And an action code is what kind of actions you would like to take in the next step. And EMI, final delivery. This is also very important. As I mentioned several times, that when we say the measurement of on-time delivery, we measure the time starting from EMD, ending to the first delivery scan. So it could be EDH or could be EMH. For the on-time delivery measurement, it is ended. No matter EDH, EDH or no matter to EMH. But for actual tracking entries, it has not ended. The customer should be satisfied if you ended by the last delivery scan, just EDH or EMH. Finally, if it is delivered or not, we don't know. I noticed that in some of the countries, you did not pay enough attention on EMI. So in most cases, some of you, after EMH or EDH, no more, nothing else. Because for the on-time delivery measurement, you finalize everything. Everything is okay for performance measurement. But for the actual situation, the customer should not be satisfied. Also, the origin country should not be satisfied because they say you attempted to deliver or you put it there. If it is finally delivered or not, nobody knows. So please remember, no matter how good you made the EDH or EMH, no matter how good your on-time delivery performance is, do not remember EMI finally. Okay, now come back to my question. What are the main functions of EDA, EDA, and EDH? It can help us a lot for the on-time delivery measurement, but it is not, they are not everything. We have to make it way to like to use them. We need to use them very correctly and reasonably. And after this presentation, I would like to ask you to do a small exercise. Small exercise, maybe something you did that before. This blue card, these are all the scans from EMA to EMI. From EMA, EMB, EX, ED, and EMC, EMB, EDB, EC, EME, blah, blah, everything. All the complete scans here. And then on this side, the red card shows the explanation for each scan. So I need each group, we will divide all people into three groups, and I need each group to put in these, first of all, these cards in proper A order, from A, from EMA to finally EMI. And then at the same time, put related explanation by the side of each scan, which what is the meaning of each scan, okay? Put them correctly. And the group who finalized the first will get the prize for one piece of chocolate. Okay, and can I divide all of you into three groups? And group one will be one, and group two will be counted as two and three. So one, two, three, and one, two, three. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, and one, two, three, one, two. Okay, and group one, maybe somewhere there, group two, somewhere here, and group three, maybe here. And who is the leader of group one? Here.